Respiratory Syncytial Virus, or RSV, is a common respiratory virus that causes infection in the lungs and respiratory tract. It is spread from person to person through coughs and sneezes, or when someone touches a contaminated surface and then touches their eyes, nose, or mouth. Symptoms of RSV can include cough, runny or stuffy nose, low-grade fever, sore throat, sneezing, and headaches. While symptoms are usually mild and cold-like, they can become severe and lead to difficulty breathing, lung infection, congestive heart failure, hospitalization, and even death, especially in young children and in older adults over the age of 65. You may have thought RSV was something only little kids get, but it's also quite common in older adults and particularly dangerous in people who have certain chronic conditions or who have declining immune systems from age or disease that can make it harder for their bodies to fight off infections and complications. RSV may be suspected when listening to the lungs with a stethoscope, but can only be diagnosed by a simple nasal swab or wash, or by nose and upper throat swab. Despite how common it is, and how severe an infection can be, RSV often goes undiagnosed. Symptoms can overlap and be mistaken for symptoms of other respiratory illnesses like the flu, a cold, or even COVID-19. These infections may even occur together, since one infection can weaken the immune system for other germs to invade. While there is not a vaccine for RSV yet, a number are in development and expected to be available soon. In the meantime, getting your flu, COVID-19, and pneumonia vaccines can help prevent additional respiratory infections. It's also important to take other precautions against the spread of infection, like hand washing, covering coughs and sneezes, disinfecting surfaces that people frequently touch, wearing masks, and staying home when sick. RSV infections are more frequent in the fall, winter, and early spring, but can happen any time of the year. Most RSV infections go away on their own in a week or two and can be treated at home by taking over-the-counter pain relievers and drinking plenty of fluids. It's important to stay home except to get medical care and to keep away from others. Some infants and people with weakened immune systems can still be contagious and spread RSV for as long as 4 weeks after the end of their symptoms. So talking to a healthcare provider about isolation is critical for keeping others safe. If you or a loved one are experiencing difficulty breathing, high fever, or cold symptoms that have become severe, it's important to contact your healthcare provider right away. If you experience any of these symptoms, get medical help immediately. Warning signs may be different in children. While RSV can be serious, staying home and protecting others when you're sick can lessen its impact. Talk to your healthcare provider and go to agingresearch.org/ourbestshot to learn more about how to decrease your risk.